Hi guys, welcome back for a very quick update regarding the new Cisco certification updates. Cisco announced that it will be updating its certification program from 24th of February 2020. That's 8 months from now. So all certifications, including the CCNA, has undergone major changes. If your question is whether you should continue doing your current CCNA or you should wait for the new CCNA, or you think this change is good or bad for you, or you want to know what else has changed, then stay tuned because we will be demystifying all about the updates from Cisco. In the last Cisco Live, Cisco announced that CCNA is going to be just one. There will be only one CCNA. There won't be CCNA Wireless, CCNA Security, CCNA Data Center, CCNA Industrial, CCNA RNS, CCNA Service Provider, CCNA Collaboration, or for that matter, there won't even be a CCDA. There's going to be only one CCNA. This also means there won't be ICND 1, ICND 2, which means there is only one way to achieve your CCNA, that is to write the new CCNA exam and pass it. Cisco also introduced a new associate level program called the Cisco Certified DevNet Associate. Now, DevNet Associate is a place where they're going to concentrate more on the software and programming side of Cisco, more to do with the software defined network. What else has changed? With CCNA, CCNP and CCIE has also changed. Currently, if you want to do your CCNP RNS, for example, you had to write three exams. So you had to write route, switch, and t-shoot. With the new CCNP, you only have to write two tests or two exams. That will be CCNP, there will be a core, and then there will be a specialist exam. They've also gone ahead and reconfigured the number of domains that is there with CCNP. So the five domains that's going to be part of CCNP is going to be Enterprise, Data Center, Security, Service Provider, and Collaboration. Just like the Associate Certification, there is a new Professional Certification called the Cisco Certified DevNet Professional. But the most important change is now, unlike before, Cisco said that every exam you write, you will get a certificate. So earlier, if you did your ICND 1 or CCENT as we call it, you did not get any certificate. Of course, because you do your ICND 1, you could do your ICND 2 and both together would give you the CCNA. Similarly, if you were doing your CCNP, if you passed any of the three papers, you know, if you pass route, switch or t-shoot, you don't get a certificate for individual three papers. If you did all three, you get a CCNP. Now Cisco wanted to change that. Cisco said every exam you pass with Cisco, you get a certificate. So if you're, let's say for instance, you're pursuing your CCNP in Enterprise, you would first write the Enterprise Core exam. So as soon as you write your CCNP Enterprise Core exam, you become a Cisco certified specialist in Enterprise Core. Then you can choose any one of these papers in Enterprise and you write that exam. Cisco gives you a Cisco certified specialist in this chosen domain. Now you get two certificates for these two. So one, you get Cisco certified specialist for Enterprise Core, and then you get Cisco certified specialist for this chosen specialist exam. But because you passed two exams in Enterprise, you become a CCNP in Enterprise. So that's so cool. You get three certificates for two exams. That's not all. Before, or rather now, in what's happening right now, see, if you wanted to do your CCNP, CCNA was a prerequisite. That means if your end objective was to get your CCNP, you had to get a CCNA because CCNA is a prerequisite. Not anymore. That wouldn't be the case from next year. So once the new exams kick in, you could directly get in, write your Enterprise Core or CCNP Core, whatever domain that you choose, and then write a specialist exam. So you just have to write two exams. You don't have a prerequisite of CCNP. That's cool, I think. CCIE, on the other hand, never had a prerequisite. So you didn't have to become a CCNP or a CCNA to do CCIE. You could become a CCIE direct. But only prerequisite, so to say, for you to get your CCIE lab or to be qualified to schedule your IE lab, you had to write something called the CCIE written exam. So you write a CCIE written exam. Again, this is one more exam where, like ICND1, you get nothing for it. You pass a CCIE written, you don't even get a certificate saying that you have passed your CCIE written. So it's just a qualifying exam, just like your another online exam, like CCNA and all the papers. But still, you write that exam, you don't get a certificate. You're just eligible to schedule a CCIE lab. And then when you pass your CCIE lab, you get one certificate for CCIE, so you're a CCIE, and that's it. From next year, with the new ones, new exams or new versions kicking, there is no more CCIE written. You will not have a paper called CCIE written. So what would happen is the core exam for CCNP, right? So if you're doing CCIE Enterprise, the CCNP Enterprise core exam, that becomes your qualifying exam. So you pass that exam, CCNP Enterprise core, you are eligible now to schedule your CCIE lab. So once you pass your enterprise core, like you know, Cisco certified specialist in enterprise, you get one certificate. You schedule your lab and you pass your lab. Because you pass your lab, you have a CCIE certificate and you are a CCIE. But now just add one more specialist exam from CCNP Enterprise. You get another Cisco certified enterprise or Cisco certified specialist in that chosen stream. Plus, because you have passed two enterprise CCNP level exams, one core and another specialist exam, you are also a CCNP. So you get four qualifications for three exams, right? So if you're anyway doing your CCIE, you just have to add one more paper and have CCNP and CCIE and four certificates. That's awesome. I think Cisco is doing all of us, you know, people who are chasing certifications after certifications. This is brilliant time because you're getting a lot of certificates. So I think on that note, I think you should go and hit that like button to tell Cisco how much you love them. Now, why is this change? Now, Cisco spoke to a lot of industry experts and hiring managers and realized that the certification should reflect today's requirements. So when for CCNA level, when hiring managers hire CCNA candidates, they expect them to have very basic knowledge and they need them to know few foundations, right? So CCNA thought they were teaching a lot more that is not required and no more relevant, you know, things that are old, right? Things that they don't really need. So they have revamped CCNA, and the current CCNA, or rather the new CCNA, will cover routing and switching, basic routing and switching, how to configure IP addresses and all that. You'll have basic wireless security, and then it will delve into automation and programmability. So automation programmability is going to be a little important aspect in Cisco and in Cisco's future. So they wanted to introduce that at CCNA level. If you were to compare the current CCNA and the new CCNA, I think Cisco has retained about 60% of current CCNA's topics, and they have added 20% more. So on the whole, if you compare topic-wise, topic breadth, to the new CCNA topic breadth, it's about 80% of the current CCNA, but again, more relevant topics. The new CCNA exam code will be 200-301, which will start on 24th of February 2020. That means on that day, ICND1, ICND2, 200-125 CCNA, the current CCNA, all these three papers will stop, right? you will not have an opportunity to write those exams on that day. So unlike before, when Cisco announces a new version, Cisco gives an overlapping period where you could choose to write between the two papers. So you had a choice between the papers. But this time, Cisco's announced it now, and Cisco's given you this 8 months period. When Cisco will stop this paper and they will introduce a new paper, right? So the old papers will go out of circulation. You cannot schedule those exams. So now for the critical question. Should you continue preparing for your current CCNA or wait for the new CCNA? To answer that question depends on a lot of factors. If you are doing your CCNA because it was a prerequisite for CCNP, then you don't really need CCNA now. You can directly attempt your CCNP, so you don't have to worry about CCNA, and go ahead and prepare for CCNP core, or rather your whatever stream that you want to choose, enterprise core in that. If you were doing CCNA because you wanted to get your CCNA certificate and you want to, you know, you're like 2-3 years, 4 years into the industry and you just want that level, your aim is to get your CCNA, then please go ahead and continue studying for your current CCNA, because you have 8 months until February 2020, and passing CCNA, I think it requires about 2 months. 2 months preparation is more than enough to pass your CCNA. So you have a lot of time and you can pass your current CCNA. The third type of people are people who chose to go through the ICND route. So if you have done your ICND 1, then you have to finish your ICND 2 before the 24th of February 2020, because on that date your ICND 1 becomes void and null. So there's no meaning with that. You cannot write ICND 2. So you have anyway invested money on ICND 1, you might have to just write your ICND 2 and get your CCNA, right? No matter what, if you choose to do your CCNA now, before 24th of February 2020, you would be awarded the new CCNA and the new training batch. So there's nothing that you're going to lose by getting your CCNA now. So there's no point saying, oh, the old CCNA, new CCNA. There's nothing called old CCNA, new CCNA. You become a CCNA now, you are a CCNA, and Cisco is going to give you the new badge on 24th of February 2020, right? So that is brilliant, and I think everybody should attempt the current CCNA. As for us, we will be updating the series, or rather we will be continuing with the current series. We'll complete it. We hopefully in the next 1 or 2 months we will finish the entire series, so you will have enough time to use our material to complete your CCNA before the February 24th, 2020. Once the new CCNA kicks in, we will also, this series will be valid, and this series is going to be online. We are not going to stop this, so it is always going to be valid. So the question of whether it's valid or not is not going to change, because whatever we taught you here, the new CCNA, like I said, will have 60% of this content. So your OSPF will remain the same, IP address schemes will remain the same, your OSI stacks will remain the same. Everything is going to be the same. There's nothing that really changes, right? Like EIGRP is no more in the new new CCNA, right? So EIGRP will go away. Doesn't mean if you have to use EIGRP in your work environment today, the EIGRP is going to be not going to be any different. It's going to be the same EIGRP, right? So you study now, whatever you're studying on our series and whatever you're studying with the current CCNA is going to be valid. Once a new CCNA kicks in, we might have a new series, right? With the 200-301 series, which will be tailor-made to the topics that's there in that series. But that doesn't mean this is going to go away. All these videos will stay online for free. The new series, the 200-301, I don't know if I'm going to leave it free. It could be a paid series. It could be something that you'll have to pay. I don't know how I'm going to do. That's a strategy that I'm going to discuss and decide when that happens, right? This series is going to be free. This series is free, and this will always remain free. So you can watch this anytime, every time. So I hope I have demystified some of the updates from Cisco and some some of your questions are answered in this. So thank you for joining me today. We'll be continuing our series, so join us there. And until I see you all guys back in that series, have a good day.